And welcome to the NFC Embedded presentation. So first, I would like to thank you very much for being here. And that is the first step for you to implement NFC inside your application. So I'm Anaïs Galigani, and this is... So first, how many of you already know what is NFC? And if you have a right answer, maybe you will be available to win some kits. So do you know what is NFC? Okay. Good. So let's review the agenda. So first we will see briefly what is NFC. Then we will see the ST and NFC story about our dynamic product. That will bring me to our portfolio. Then we will see the use case for NFC. And at the end, the conclusion. There will be a small time for ask and question where you'll be again able to win some kits. The presentation will last around 20 minutes and around 10 minutes for ask and question. So the first part, so what is NFC? So near field communication. So it is a close cousin of RFID, radio frequency identification. So as it is said for NFC forum, I quote, NFC technology enables simple and safe two-way interaction between electronic devices. So the electronic devices is also your application. As you can see, there is home automation, home appliance, fitness, wellness, gaming, industrial, there is a lot of different type of market where you can implement NFC. The only limit is your imagination. Oh yes, and also on the market concerning NFC, as also concerning the smartphone, there was 424 million of NFC smartphones last year that were shipped, and this year it will be around, it will increase of 70%. So now let's see how ST brings to life the dynamic tag. So how, maybe you already know, the heart of my division, the memory, is the E2PROM, so a non-volatile memory. So it means it's a memory where you can still access even if it's not parallel. So it's a memory that a long, long time ago was created from ST, and with the year coming, it was more and more reliable with, like, now it's 200 years of data retention and 4 million of cycles. So it's very reliable and very robust. And then she has a cousin, RFID tag. So this product was very good, you know, for parameter management during the manufacture. Very, very good. And this one, RFID tag, so it's RF. And the E2PROM was saying, oh, but the RFID tag is lucky because she can communicate outside of the wall. And the RFID tag was saying about the E2PROM, oh, but she's lucky because she can communicate with I2C to the microcontroller. So that's why we, ST, as the creator of the E2PROM and the RFID tag, we have been creating the dynamic tag, the M24SR and the M24LR. And we were the first on the market with this product. So now let's go a bit more in details concerning this product. So the two families, so there is two different types of protocol. So the first is ISO 14443. It means you have the highest data rate, 106 kilobits per second. As there is the highest data rate, we'll have the highest read range. So you will have a smallest, highest consumption, so smallest read range. And the M24LR, it's ISO 15693, so it's NFC compatible. And as the data rate is 26 kilobits per second, it's the smallest read range. It's the smallest consumption, so better read range. Sorry. The M24SR is optimized for the speed, and the M24LR is optimized for the range. So we have around 28 parts for each of the memory, so we have a lot of portfolio that will help you concerning the flexibility inside your application. So did I just speak about read range? So just to show you the difference concerning read range, concerning NFC and RFID. So concerning NFC, with a smartphone, you can go up to 5 or 7 centimeters, either it is the M24SR or the LR. And with the RFID reader, you can go up to 10 centimeters or 1 meter. This is really linked to the technology and modulation and everything, but we are not going inside the equation, don't worry. So of course, this is also dependent of the size of the antenna, the size of the antenna of the tag, of the reader, and the power. So it's not magic. Huh? There is equation behind this. So then let's see how the M24SR portfolio is made. So we have four different type of package: TSSOP, MLP, SO8, and also wafers. And there is four different type of memories: 2, 4, 16, and 64 kilobits. There is a specificity: we have a high speed, so 1 megahertz for I2C, the serial interface. And we have two specific functions. One is RF enable, disable. If you want, for example, to hide that there is an NFC component inside your application, and then you can activate it per I2C depending on of your application. Then there is what we call a general purpose pin that will allow you, for example, to say to the micro, hey, wake up, or hey, there is an interrupt. So that is for the M24SR. Then concerning the M24LR, we have still the same package, SO8, TSSOP, MLP, and wafers. We have three different type of size of memory: 4, 16, and 64 kilobit. Here we have, so the specific function is, there is also a RF-free busy pin that allows to say to the micro, hey, wake up, or hey, there is a RF communication. So to have the ability to say to the micro, wake up, or whatever, is helping to save the battery lifetime, for example. And there is a energy harvesting function. So it means, energy harvesting means that the component will harvest the extra energy that is not used to other components, as per a micro, as per a temperature sensors, as per LCD screen. And here the voltage on this part is 1.8 and 5.12 voltage. And of course, all of these components are passive. It means you can still access this even if your device is not powered. So it's very good for manufacturing line, as Martin will explain you later. Then let's study a bit more about the architecture of these both products. So as all the protocols are already inside the memory, you won't have to add anything. And plus, on our micro, we are providing the firmware. So for you, it's very easy to implement it. And also, maybe you say, but I want to do an NFC application. I want an Android application. Then we are providing the source code of the Android application in order to make your design easy and fastest. But you say, but there is an antenna. And what is about antenna? So concerning antenna, there is three different types of way to design to make the antenna integration. So just to show you, so the pointer. So concerning the onboard antenna, so this is good because this is on your PCB, so it's costless. But of course, maybe you will say, but I don't have enough space on my PCB. And I will say, but there is always some solution. For example, you can do what I say, surrounding antenna around your PCB, so you won't see it inside your application. It's like transparent for you. Then the second option is onboard inductor. The inductor, as there is ferrite on it, is very good when you have a metal. But of course, the wind range will be smallest that compared with the biggest antenna. And then there is off-board antenna, where you can use, for example, a flexible PCB. You see flexible PCB? So it will be off-board. So of course, the only difference between this one and the other one is that the chip won't be able to communicate, at least when the antenna is not connected to the chip. That's the only point. And then we have just been releasing this month a new product. It's much more than an NFC tag, but it's not yet a dynamic tag. I mean, there is no serial interface, I2C, but there is one pin. That is why there is much more than an NFC tag. The pin is GPO, so it can always say to the micro, hey, wake up, or hey, there is an RF operation, or hey, there is an interrupt. We have two different types of memory, 512 bit and 2K bit. There is also 20 bit counter that will help you to count if there is how many read or how many write. So this is it, and we are offering it also in a very small package, DFN5, that is a very small wine. So this is very good for your application. And now let's see the plastic NFC and the RFID tag. So I just want you to remember, you need NFC or RFID, ST has all the product that you need. So concerning the NFC tag, we have either ISO 15693 with two different types of memory, 2 or 64. So this is for industrial application when you need a read range. Then we have also SRT and SRI series. These products are used a lot in mass transit and ticketing. Then we have just released the SRTAG 2KL or SRTAG series. So for example, as you can see on our booth, we are offering business card because as it is the biggest memory for NFC tags, you will be able to program your pictures or your logo inside the NFC tag. Okay, so now I bring you by the presentation to Martin.
Hello and good afternoon also from my side. What I would like to show you is something different. I would like to bring you from 2 or 8-pin devices to a bit more complex one, to the devices that are active, to the transceivers, to the family of 95HF products that you can see already in the screen. So in the naming of NFC Forum and following the NFC specifications, you can meet actually three main roles in the NFC that an object can take and act accordingly. So you can see a product that is named RX95HF and making the card emulation. This is one of the roles. CR95HF, that is the reader-writer. And then we have the ST95HF in the family. That is superset of the previous two and that is able to make the card emulation, reader-writer, and also peer-to-peer communication in the NFC world. All these devices are active components, means that you need, in this case, a power supply. The payback for you is that you have a higher reader range and possible faster communication speeds. So every technology, the passive RFID tags or semi-passive dynamic NFC tags has some benefits, but the readers for sure as well. And this is mainly the communication speed and the communication distance that can be better than in case of previous two. Again, you can see a list of the ISO specifications that these devices are following. These are the worldwide and open specifications. And as the interfaces that we are using to drive, to control, to set up these transceivers to do their job are SPI and UART. Every complex or simple technology needs to be supported. I know our developers like to be supported from the hardware, from the software point of view. So we have prepared a slide showing only a few of the evaluation or discovery boards that we have prepared during the years for you. So from the left side, it is the M24LR series and M24LR discovery that actually composed of two boards. The red one is the one showing the M24LR functionality, the energy harvesting that was presented just before. And the green one that gives you the CR95HF evaluation board, that is actually the reader-writer. So even if you don't have possibly the smartphone with the NFC interface, if you start with the M24LR discovery, you can get the passive side, the dynamic NFC tag, but also the active component, the CR95HF, the reader-writer, the entity that brings the energy into the system. In the middle, you can see the M24SR series. So even here, we have prepared discovery boards that can quickly help you to explain how to use or what is the good things about the NFC, how to use the NDEF messaging. And of course, we do follow also the Expansion Shield initiative. I'm sure you know STM32 Nucleo boards and the shields that we are offering together in this infrastructure or this ecosystem. So even here we have prepared the M24SR Nucleo expansion board that is shown in the picture. Last but definitely not least are the boards supporting or helping to start the development on the transceivers. So you may see the RX95 HF evaluation board for the card emulation evaluation, and pair of ST95 HF boards named EVAL ST95 HF that help you quickly start with the peer-to-peer communication. We have spoken about the hardware. Part of the hardware is definitely the antenna. The analysts show you before how the antenna can be positioned inside your application. This slide would like to demonstrate or document the fact that we are supporting you also in the antenna design. That is, I believe, quite simple. However, a computation tool that is available on myst.com should make it even easier for you. The tool is there to give you the first estimation of the correct antenna impedance or inductance that you need to design in order to match the criteria of the resonance. Because you may know that, especially in the passive devices, we have certain internal capacitance, and the task of the designer who designs the antenna for the tag or for dynamic NFC tag is to match with the right inductance. So this tool is there, available for you, and can give you the first estimation, the first approach to have a good design of the antenna. Okay, in the next slides, I would like to briefly go with you through the major use cases that we see today in the market for the NFC. And in case you don't have an idea in the moment where I can use the NFC, this should give you the answer. So the first one is coming from manufacturing and logistic branch. And the motive behind, or the idea behind, is that you may be a manufacturer of the components or of the applications that you need to sell around the globe. So you need to sell something to Germany, something to France, to Italy, to US, to China. And in the moment, you may face a need to configure every application that you need to deliver to different countries in a particular way. You need to set up the language set, you need to set up some frequencies for the particular country, for the particular market. The idea of NFC, once you have it embedded in your application, for example, the dynamic NFC tag, that don't need any powering for the operation, is to embed to change the parameters or the configuration for the last moment, just before the shipment. For example, on the conveyor belt, like it is shown in the slide, with the industrial reader that is able to cover all the volume of the cartoon box, for example, where is located the application itself. And you can, in the last minute, change the welcome message from German language to English language or to Chinese, in case of need. Another application is also quite popular. We call it NFC remote programming. And this one is very close to our digestion, to our stomach. We take an example of the smart kitchen, where you have a NFC-enabled oven. And because not each of us is general chief, and we may have sometimes an issue how to set up the oven to have the perfect turkey before the Christmas period, we can use, again, an NFC. You can download the recipe with your smartphone from the internet and just pass the cooking recipe into the oven through the NFC. The concept behind is clear. Again, there is a small amount of data that you need to pass from the smartphone from the application that you master pretty good into the appliance or into your application. Another one that is also quite popular and should improve the experience with the smartphone or with the modern components or devices is the wireless pairing. These days it is mainly for the Wi-Fi and Bluetooth, where we have standards behind. The NFC forum defines how to make the Bluetooth or Wi-Fi pairing. So the infrastructure for this procedure is already today in your smartphones. You just need to explore it. And again, the task is to simplify, to improve your life in the sense that you don't need to enter into the menus and try to search for the PIN. You simply take your smartphone, you touch your hi-fi system, and the beauty behind, the technique behind, makes the connection, makes the handover of the Bluetooth to from your smartphone to the hi-fi, stereo. Next one is a more industrial one. Again, good demonstration of the bidirectional communication, because we have a chance not only to pass the information from the smartphone inside the application, but we are for sure able with the NFC download the data from the device. So this can be the case of the maintenance record need. Once is your appliance equipped with the NFC, you can use your tablet or smartphone to download the data inside, make the necessary analysis, and for sure react accordingly. You can download back the new parameters, the new settings, simply make the control of the appliance through the NFC. So far I was speaking mainly about the use cases that are related to the dynamic NFC tags or to the transceivers. I would like to mention also a few of them that are tied closely to the tags only, to the NFC tags, to the devices that has only two pins or three pins, so antenna and maybe the wake-up line. I will speak about the SR tag L use cases mainly. The very first one and very popular these days are the use cases based on the location. So the use cases where you place the tag next to your bed, in the car, in your office, and when you are moving in between these locations, you place the smartphone on the tag next to your bed. It makes automatically the job of turning off the sound, maybe turn off the wireless communication. In your car, it can connect again automatically to your hi-fi. At your office, it can start the Bluetooth and the Wi-Fi, make the synchronization of your email account. So this is the location-based profiles or location-based use cases. Another one, quite popular, that we have mentioned here as well already, is the V-card. So even here, we again can benefit from the infrastructure, from the specification that are already in the place, that are defined by the NFC forum, and that enables you, for example, in case of writing the right NDEF message, with the help of the NFC, the visit card, a contact card that you can use as many times as you like. You don't need to print hundreds of the paper cards anymore. If you have the visit card in NFC, you can simply introduce it to the smartphone of your company partner, and the contact informations are copied, and you can use it as many times as you like. The unique feature of our SRTEC 64 was mentioned already before. So you are not limited in storing only the name, email address, and the postal address of yours, but you can, thanks to the big memory capacity, you can store also the logo or the picture with the text message or with the text information as well. In the next slide, I would like to give you some evidence or explain our motivation in promoting or in bringing new products to the NFC market. It is mainly given or driven by the split of the operating systems between the smart devices. As you can see, this market is dominated by the Android devices that are today in 99% equipped with the NFC interface. And thanks to this, we can enjoy that everybody who has the Android device today in the pocket most probably have the NFC reader there as well, even if they may not know. So this is the split, this is the motivation for us. The number of phones in the market were mentioned before. There are constantly growing, and everybody of us has the reader in the pocket, and we should use it. So to sum up on the portfolio, I would like that you take from this presentation that whatever you need for the NFC solution, you may get in ST, because we have the complete portfolio now where you can get the tags, dynamic NFC tags, or the active components, the transceivers. And it is a good entry point for your application or for your use cases to enter the Internet of Things, because the NFC is a great opportunity to manage a lot of wireless or a lot of object-to-object communication tasks. I would like that you keep in mind, especially from the beginning of the presentation, that this technology has mainly positive power consumption effect to your application. So in the majority of the cases, in the majority of the application, you don't need to spare some extra power budget for the NFC because of the passive principles that we were showing before. And I hope that you take from this presentation also that the implementation is quite simple. We have a lot of examples in terms of evaluation boards, in terms of discovery boards. I would like to invite you to our tripod that is next to this place, to the theater, where we can discuss and we can show you more evaluation boards and how simple or complicated maybe for you is to design the antenna. And in order to check that you have listened and that you get the messages, I would like to ask some questions that can be rewarded by a discovery boards or kits. So we have plenty of them. Let's start with the simple question. What ISO specifications we follow with M24LR and SR series? Yes, but it is ISO 1800, for example, ISO 15693, ISO 14443. What is the answer? 14443 is certainly there. This is ISO 14443. Some other ISO norms? My point is that we cover all the general or all the open standards that are available. So for all of them, for the long range or for the short range, you can stop by and get a product from us. Okay, another question. What is the biggest memory capacity we offer on the LR and SR series of tags and the dynamic tags? Quite unique feature that we have. I can help you, the product name somehow encapsulates the memory capacity, and we were speaking here about the SRTech 64K. So just translate this into some memory capacity. This would be perfect, it is 64K bit. Another question may be related again to the dynamic tags. How many pins on the devices we have? How many pins you need to solder in order to get an NFC link into your application? Best case, worst case? Two pins are minimum, that's correct. The point is to solder at least the antenna, absolutely. Some other ideas? M24LR04, for example, dynamic NFC tag that has the RF interface and the I2C bus. How many pins the chip has?
Oh, eight.
Very good. This is 8-pin device. Anais were showing the packages SO8, MLP8, DSSOP8. Do you have a question? Another one?
Are the packages P2P compatible?
There was a slide showing you how difficult it is to move with the M24 LR design into the M24 SR. Question is, are these devices somehow compatible? Is it difficult to move from one ISO standard to another one? Very good. It is really simple. The design is done intentionally in the way that in case you have started with M24 LR series, because you want to enjoy the long range robustness of the protocol ISO 15693, and you need or you find interesting to move to ISO 14443, it is not difficult because the design, the internal capacitance is fine-tuned in the way that you can really seamless move from the LR to SR. Okay, I think I have no more questions. I would like to thank you once again for your attention, for staying with us. I hope you have learned something new. And as a last thing, I would really like to invite you, as Anais mentioned before, to grab an NFC visit card that you can get free of charge at our hostesses, and that helps you to participate, or that enables you to participate to the evening lottery. At 5 o'clock, you can come back, and with your new NFC visit card, you can win some nice prizes. So.